Hey there, friendlies. How is up? Got another whiskey review for you here at the Dribs and Drams online extravaganza. Today we're doing Ardbeg An Oa. Never tried an An Oa before. This An Oa is very marketing-y with all this special stuff around it. This is called the barbecue smoker. You may not find one with all this marketing piffle on it, but what's inside is the important thing here. So, let's get it open, shall we? What's the barbecue smoker? Well, it's a very big, pointlessly spiffy metal canister. And this is the barbecue smoker here, okay? Obviously you put your, I guess, cherry nuggets or nuggets, the cherry chips or whatever in there. If you're big on barbecuing, that may be cool. This may be a selling point. Here we go, bottle. Let's get all this stuff out of the way. So, open the bottle. I forgot my knife and I forgot my axe, so we're just gonna have to do it by hand this time because of the cinema verite aspect. Here we go. Wish I brought my knife. There we go, and that's a pretty good sound, actually. Can we get that again, or is it just the first one? Yeah, it's nice. Right. Let's pour it. Nice color. So, An Oa, I mean, I've never had An Oa before. What I've read is that this is supposed to be their most rounded release. I have no idea. So what do we got? We got some ex-bourbon oak. We got PX cherry oak, and there's some virgin oak barrelage as well. So what am I expecting? I'm expecting the usuals from a bourbon barrel, some vanilla, some butterscotch, some dark fruit probably from the sherry, and I guess the virgin oak will give us a little bit of spice, a little bit of zing. This is a no age statement, so I'm expecting it to be pretty lively, and of course I'm expecting a little bit of smoke on there, maybe some barbecue or something, because I mean there has to be a reason why they picked this one to do the smoker. Let's talk about this packaging first off. This is all marketing piffle, okay? But it's really nice. It's very nicely done, very classy. This tin is likely gonna be useless. This, if you're into smoking your stuff, which I kind of am actually, is a nice touch. This is not the kind of nice touch that would sell me on the bottle. I bought it from Alberta. It was on sale for the same price as just a straight up bottle, and there was no stock of just the straight up bottle. I do believe that there's a bit of a missed opportunity here though, because you know what this should have come with? Oak staves. These are whiskey barrel stave chunks that a friend of mine uses in his big green egg. And I just think like some shavings off of retired whiskey barrels in like a little Ziploc or something inside, just as a finishing touch, would have been a real plus. So nice. I don't know what whiskey this barrel was, but yeah, that would have been a nice touch. So yeah, I like the packaging. As far as the actual label goes, it's your very typical Ardbeg label. I think the Ardbeg look is nice. I love the green bottle, but it's kind of looks a little dated. It's always the same sort of variant on the knotwork. They have a style and they stick with it. It's not a very exciting style, but it's recognizable, you know, and I like it. I like it. Actually, before we do the nosing and the tasting and all that stuff, let's do Jesse's checklist, shall we? So with the An Oa, we have single malt. We have 46.6% alcohol by volume, I believe, yes. We have no age statement, unfortunately. But also, as per German online retailers, we have no chill filtering and no caramel coloring. So that's pretty good. I still call that a win. So let's take a look. So if that's no caramel coloring and no chill filtering, I think that's really nice. Look at that golden straw color. As I turn it around, I'm looking to see if we got tears. Not a lot of tears happening. So I'm expecting a little bit of an oily feel in the mouth. So let's stick it up the schnoz, shall we? That's recognizably Ardbeg right off the bat. Yeah, so that's the Ardbeg smoke and peat. There's a freshness to it. I can tell you right now that there's some spice going on in there. And a sweetness, a little bit of an espresso. A little treacle or something. And a bit of brine. Let's go in. Let's give it a taste. Man, you guys can't see this, but there's a lot of birds right next to me here. Let's go. Okay, a little burnt toast. There's a caramel there. Oh, there's a drying thing though. Like really, like pew. My tongue is suddenly arid. Spice, dark fruits. Maybe a plum jam, malty. Nicely peaty. Very nice. Very, very nice. Is it my favorite Ardbeg? Hard to say. More interesting in some ways than the 10. More of a rounded effect than the Wee Beastie for sure. Because that one's all about attack. But I don't know if it's better than the Ugadal. That Ugadal is pretty nice. I was surprised by the drying aspect. Let me go to the nose again, now that I've tasted it. Now the brown sugar is bigger. Still, there's a lot of caramel. It's like a creme brulee. Still nicely fruity. Maybe I'm saying plum, but sort of a dark berry thing as well. Maybe a bit of cherry. There's a pastry aspect here. Something about the smokiness and the fruitiness and the maltiness is making me think of some kind of a fruit pastry. Like a jammy pastry. Very nice. Very, very nice. Gonna go in again. No surprises. It's still very similar. The espresso note comes in bigger at the back end though. Yeah, I like it. I like it. I'm definitely calling this that's an 86. Also, nicely oily in the mouth. Still some spice. There's a cooling aspect to it. Something about it drying my mouth out right away gives me a cooling aspect. Like when I do that, it's almost like right after you've brushed your teeth with a minty toothpaste. I don't mean it's minty toothpaste. I'm saying that the feel is there. And the finish is still going. You know, I'd call that a medium long finish. Let's destroy it, shall we? I don't want to put a whole bunch in there because I'm down a bit. Giving it the swooshy swoosh. Some of the spice is toned down. Some of the sweet is bigger, so it's mellowed out a bit. Creme brulee is still there. Not picking up the espresso as much on the nose. The drying aspect is tamped down. The spice is tamped down. Look, a lot of the same flavors are there. But it's a little hollowed out. I've said that about certain whiskeys before, that it's watered down a little bit, even though I didn't add a whole lot. Down around 46%, adding water is more of a wild card than when you got something cask strength, where sometimes you gotta just sort of tamp it down a bit. I do not prefer this with the water. So look, as far as value goes, look, it's under $100. In Alberta, this is a $95 bottle, with or without all the smoker piffle. I mean, that gets it high marks for value. I like it. The packaging I find relatively pointless, but it's classy, nicely done. And I'm glad to have this bottle. So, that's all she wrote. As I always say, if you like what I'm doing, then please, please, please do the following three things. One, comment down below. What's the next Ardbeg I should try? Should I go big on the Liqueur Bracken? Because in Quebec, it's expensive as hell. Aside from that, please share this video. That helps me more than you could possibly imagine. And then, after all that, please leave me a smiley thumb. If you don't like what I'm doing, that's all right. Leave me a frowny thumb. Thanks for watching, guys.